Is OPC UA the future of IoT? Answering your questions. Question number three, take zero. All right, so the last question I'm gonna answer for now is, you wanna read the question from the guy?
Komal Butt said, sir, please make a video to give a comparison between PLC versus SCADA versus DCS and how it pertains to OPC UA.
All right, so the question was, can you please make a video that compares PLC versus SCADA versus DCS as how it pertains to OPC UA. All right, so in order to do that, I gotta define these things. All right, so this is actually very simple. So our PLC is our programmable logic controller out in the field. The programmable logic controller has I/O, inputs and outputs. It's got a little processor running on it. It's got some software running. Generally, you can connect to it and you can write a control program that basically can read inputs and based on certain conditions, make changes to outputs, right? That's your PLC. The SCADA system, supervisory control and data acquisition, is a software layer that is designed to centrally control and acquire data from many PLCs, okay? So I may have my SCADA system here, my SCADA may talk to another PLC. The big thing that SCADA does is it gives you control and it gives you alarming. That's really the big thing that SCADA does, is it tells us when we have a problem. But it's central. Supervisory control and data acquisition is central. DCS is very similar to SCADA, but think of it as proprietary, okay? My SCADA system, if I buy an off-the-shelf piece of SCADA software, it generally doesn't care who the manufacturer of this hardware in the field is, okay? It can talk to Allen Bradley, it can talk to Siemens, it can talk to Emerson, it can talk to anything, right? The SCADA software is generally open and it can talk to anything, okay? A DCS system is generally, in most cases, it's process specific, and it's all of this stuff turnkey process specific. So a DCS system, a distributed control system, has a SCADA component, okay? It has a SCADA component. It has a PLC, and oftentimes they call it either a RIO, an RTU, or a PLC. It has a hardware component, okay? Out in the field. Most of the time, that hardware in the field also talks to one another directly. So I may have a RIO, a remote I/O card that's at the beginning of my process, and one halfway through my process, another one further up from my process. There's some intelligence going on, some I/O, some intelligence going on the edge, and then I have a massive controller in a control room that's generally between this SCADA layer. This is where the process control is taking place. This is where the program is running. And then my SCADA layer is really a node in the system, okay? So in distributed control systems, I may buy a DCS from ABB. So for example, in the steel industry, you use distributed control in your rolling mill because the technology required, the program required to run a rolling mill, to turn a big billet into rebar, is millions of lines of automation code. So what happens is ABB writes the code one time. You buy the distributed control system. They install all the I/O, they install the process control center, they install the SCADA interface in the control room, then they connect all that together, and then they add in some custom stuff. Oh, I might add in some additional I/O to turn a water valve on here and there, and you can add in custom process control. But with a distributed control system, you almost always come with a prepackaged program in that DCS to run your process. And then you kind of add on to it. With PLCs and SCADA system, think of them as blank slates, right? When I buy an Allen Bradley Control Logics, it doesn't have a program on it. I can take a program I've already written and put it on there, or I can just write a new one from scratch, which is the way it normally works. A distributed control system can come completely blank, but in this day and age, normally it does not. Normally the DCS comes with the program to run your process already loaded onto it. Here's the reason you use a distributed control system, is these almost always talk to one another over a super high-speed field bus, okay? So generally, these connections are not direct copper connections, and they're not over Ethernet, and they're not over fiber. Most of the time, the SCADA control unit and all your remote IOs and your process controllers are connected over some type of field bus. So think of DCS as a turnkey solution that you can add on to control your process. And that turnkey solution includes the SCADA component. But let's say I add a new process to my plant. So I install a new scale, okay, because I want to weigh rail cars or something. So I add a new PLC, and I've got a rail car that I want to weigh, okay? And this scale, this Mettler-Toledo scale, comes up into that PLC. Most of the time, you are not going to add the SCADA interface to the DCS SCADA system. Why? Because it takes too long to do it. Right.
Can you bring the DCS into a SCADA?
You can, yeah. And here's why, because you know the companies that make DCS systems like ABB, there are drivers that give us the ability to talk from our SCADA system through, for example, Kepware, to their field bus system.
All right.
Okay? So the answer, that's the difference. The difference is that think of SCADA and PLC as the blank slate, the open architecture, and think of DCS as the turnkey solution. But if we were to Venn diagram their functionalities, the two circles would nearly stand right on top of one another.
So like a car would be like a DCS kind of?
A car would be a DCS. The electronic control module, the ECM module, the flow control module, the exhaust control module, those are all distributed control systems for your car. The unit itself, whatever they call it, you know, like on my Cadillac, they call it something link. That is the DCS for my Cadillac, right? On Tesla, all Tesla vehicles are distributed control systems, okay? Whereas the PLC is the actual brick, it's the hardware, and the SCADA system is the piece of software. The distributed control system is the completed solution.
Like your Lego automation kit would be more PLC SCADA. Like you can kind of build your own.
Correct. That's exactly it. Yeah, PLC SCADA would be more like Lego or Minecraft. Think of it as Minecraft. PLC SCADA is like Minecraft. A distributed control system is going to be like Mario level builder. It comes prepackaged and ready to go, but you can build your own levels if you want to.
Like Alan Bradley's plant packs.
Yeah, Alan Bradley's plant packs is another good. In fact, Alan Bradley's plant packs was an approach at answering DCS. For Alan Brad, for Rockwell. Anyway, that was a really good question, and thanks for watching.